The private security firm formerly known as Blackwater is on trial in the U.S. over allegations that it killed innocent civilians in Iraq 4 years ago, but because two ex-employees claim the company overcharged Washington for protecting State Department staff in war zones. The firm, which is now called Z, provides more mercenaries for the U.S. in Afghanistan than anyone else and has been implicated in a number of scandals. In 2007, its hired guns were accused of shooting dead 17 unarmed civilians in Baghdad. Despite a lengthy legal process, no one was punished over the alleged massacre. The company is now set to take an even bigger role in Afghanistan as the U.S. withdraws its combat troops. And as RT's Gayane Chichakyan reports, there is concern Washington could keep covering for its hired killers.
This Iraqi man's son, 9-year-old Ali Kinani, was shot dead by private American war contractors 4 years ago.
His brain fell to the ground between my feet.
On the same day, dozens of other innocent Iraqis were shot by trigger-happy U.S. professional killers.
They shot like they were trying to kill everyone they could see.
No one at Blackwater, the firm for whom the hired guns worked, has been punished for the massacre. Two other private American security companies were contracted to carry out interrogations at the notorious Abu Ghraib prison in Iraq, a name synonymous now with horrific human rights violations, including torture, rape, and murder. The U.S. Supreme Court recently threw out a lawsuit alleging abuse of prisoners by the contractors. In Afghanistan, it's reported that human rights violations and even killings are committed by security firms on a regular basis, to an extent set to undermine coalition forces' counterinsurgency efforts.
They'll start firing at anything that moves. They'll injure or kill innocent Afghans, and they'll destroy property.
We're getting fairly consistent complaints about them. Everybody knows somebody who's been shot by the contractors.
The lack of accountability has forced the United Nations Working Group on Mercenaries to push for specific international measures to regulate their activities. Especially now, as U.S. military forces withdraw from Iraq and Afghanistan, the number of contractors is set to grow dramatically.
U.S. government has outsourced many of the military and security functions to these private military and security companies. They are not regulated, and they are not controlled. And this is what we are extremely concerned at. What we are calling is for regulation at the national and at the international level, so that these companies are accountable.
But Washington is reluctant to let an international body regulate their activities, saying it will find ways to hold contractors accountable. But so far, the U.S. justice system has largely failed to do so.
We're seeing around the world cases of kidnapping, rape, murder, and we see only very rare cases in which there's actually a criminal investigation or a prosecution arising out of them.
Experts say further privatization of war is convenient for the American government because, among other reasons, it doesn't have to justify the deaths of troops at home.
The president, whoever the president may be, can get us involved in conflicts only using uniform forces to do the official fighting, and then thousands and thousands of contractors to do the unofficial fighting that's under the radar screen that isn't covered by the media.
Now, here is a quote. We cannot win a fight for hearts and minds when we outsource critical missions to unaccountable contractors. End of quote. That's what Senator Obama said before he became president. But apparently, as a president, now he thinks differently, with a contractor's role in America's wars bound to increase and with the victims of their crimes still begging for justice. I'm Gayane Chichakyan reporting from Washington, RT.